how do you balance your professional and personal, especially since you have that cute little bunch at home? And we see all those selfies on Twitter, and I keep going like, because my babies are a senior and a 13-year-old, so I miss that.
Yeah, I don't know if balance is the right word, because you know there's no magic formula for that, but I have become a lot better at kind of shutting down and not looking at things, and you know, I actually wrote about this. I sent out an email today about this, and basically saying like you have to be really thoughtful of who you spend your time with, because the people that we're surrounded by. Let's say someone is just totally negative on my case all the time. Well, that interaction I have with them for the 20, 35 minutes can lead to me being bothered by it for hours, right? And I know that sometimes that's easier said than done, because that could be your boss, could be your partner as a teacher, you know, someone else. And I think that's really important for me. But I really try to, when I'm home, because I travel quite a bit, I try to be home. And I felt that when COVID happened, because I was traveling all the time before, obviously, because I was speaking and traveling, it was when I was home, I tried to do everything on a plane, right? So like when I got home, I didn't have that, but my time was limited. And then COVID actually started happening. And I'm like, okay, well, this is going to be interesting. I'm going to be home all the time. And what I found was I was home, but I wasn't present. And those things are very different. And I try to make sure that I have time away. I have learned, I think this is probably the most important advice I can give to a teacher. And unfortunately, too many teachers will not listen to me. You need to learn to say no. You need to say, no, I can't do this. I can't have this thing. I can't have this. I can't do this thing for you. Because we so go out of our way to help people, whether they're strangers, whether they're kids and not. And I think that you have to pick and choose those situations. But I feel like too many times as a teacher, and I think sometimes we actually take advantage, especially of teachers new to the profession that are trying to figure stuff out. And then we're like getting them a coach, getting them to do this. And in Canada, it's a little bit different because it's all volunteer. There's no payment for it to do this. And I think we overwhelm people so much. And so I think part of it is actually saying no. And as a principal, I will be honest with you. And this is before I had kids. I would get on teachers' cases if I felt they were at school too long, and say like you need to go home. You cannot be here all night. This is not good. And I think I read something once. I thought, you know, sometimes that's okay for some people, because that they might be avoiding something. They might be like, maybe something going on, you know, elsewhere in their lives, that work is a safe place for them, or they feel more comfortable in that space and trying to be. And obviously I got to work on being empathetic on that. But I feel sometimes we are doing so much work for the kids, but not tapping into the kids in the classrooms in front of us. And I tried to model that too. Like I know this sounds weird, but I usually would spend Friday nights at the school, not like overnight, but I would stay there late because most teachers would actually leave early on that day. And that was like my one day to be there. But most of the days as a principal, I left right after school because I wanted to go work out, and it made me feel better. And I think we tend to let ourselves depreciate in health and wellness, but take care, but try to make, but we then talk, like so many teachers have said, like, don't you think balance is important? I'm like, well, are you balanced? And like, no. I'm like, well, you're not even modeling it. You're not even doing those things. And I think part of it is you have to figure out what works for you. Like I actually, I think Lauren and I have had conversations about this. I don't take any, when I'm home and I'm like independent, I don't take anything before noon. That's my time with my family. That's my time for my health. And it's different obviously as your teacher, but you got to say like, where am I at? What do I need to actually be healthy and figure out that for yourself? And I figured it out, and I wish I could say I'm the best dad in the world, but I got a lot of work to do, and I want to be really present for my kids. And I don't know if I'm succeeding all the time, but it's a challenge for all of us too.